I'd like to talk about the characteristics of old growth forests, and here is a picture of an old growth forest in Olympic National Park in Washington. And the huge tree that you see here is a ancient Douglas fir. It's probably 1,000 years old, and that's one of the characteristics, is to have these very old, large Douglas firs, or if you're in a redwood forest, very old, large redwoods. Another characteristic of old growth forest is it has a multi-layered canopy. That means you have various layers of trees. Now, this is a picture I took of a tropical rainforest in Costa Rica because I don't have any good pictures of the multi-layered canopy of an old growth forest. But here you can see an emergent tree very high above the level of another tree layer here. And then we have another tree layer down here. And so we have multi layers to the canopy, or we have trees of different sizes and different ages. This is from University of Washington, and they had a set of gondolas that they could take up high in the canopy. It's no longer functioning, but when they were doing it was a $1 million project, and I'd like to read their description of what it's like to go up high in the canopy of an old growth forest. Our first stop, about 30 feet up, was in the mid canopy, where the forest opens and light pours in. Here you can see the shapes of the firs, cedars, and hemlocks, and the gappiness of the spaces that separate them, a term coined here at the Wind River facility. These gaps in the stand create flyways for birds and flying squirrels. And that gappiness is something you can't see when you're standing on the forest floor. And someday I would like to get a chance to go up in the canopy and get a chance to experience that. A fairly new method of being able to measure the multi-layered canopies is a thing called LIDAR, where a plane flies over and sends a laser pulse that bounces down and then back up and hits a sensor in the plane. And you can see this bridge here, what it looks like just looking at the bridge, and you can see the LIDAR image that was created. And so notice it shows different heights, the top of the bridge, the bottom of the bridge, and the canyon below the bridge. And then this is a LIDAR picture of a old growth forest. In fact, I'll read this to you. This LIDAR image shows a canopy height profile across a narrow transect through a 500-year-old Douglas fir forest. Each dot represents a hit and return of a laser pulse, and the colors indicate the height. And so notice we have different colors and different heights, or we have a multi-layered canopy in that forest. And then just another couple of pictures showing you the multi-layered canopy. And look at the guy on the right standing next to this large old tree, just to give you a feeling for the size of some of the trees in the old growth forest. And then you have various layers, including a shrub layer, not just layers of trees, but layers of shrubs. And notice that the shrub layer is pretty dense. It would be pretty hard to hike through this forest with all these shrubs on the forest floor, but you do have a lot of downed logs also. And it turns out that it's easier for a tree seedling to get established on a downed log than it would be on this very crowded forest floor. And so downed logs act as a nursery for tree seedlings. And here you can see a couple of trees that actually got established on this downed log. And so they germinated and started growing on the decomposing material of the log. And then when they got bigger, their trees wrapped around the log and finally penetrated the soil in the forest floor. And these decomposing logs not only support tree seedlings, which again you can see here, but as they decompose, they funnel nutrients back into the ecosystem. These downed logs also help prevent soil erosion, especially on a steep slope when water is coming down. They act as a dam where litter and soil will accumulate and not be washed down into the streams. And then downed logs and streams are also very important because they create pools and riffles, And having quiet areas and areas where the water is moving rapidly provides aquatic habitat for many animals. Some animals prefer the fast water, and some animals prefer the calmer water. And then trees that die and are left standing are called snags. And this is a picture of a snag. And the dead tree will have fungus attack it and insects attack it, and the wood is much softer than a living tree. And so these are what cavity nesters, animals that drill holes or cavities in the tree to nest in, prefer. And in a cavity nester, an example would be a woodpecker. And woodpeckers prefer snags, and in fact, a healthy living tree would be very difficult for them to create a cavity in. And then here you can see evidence of a hole created by a woodpecker for its eggs to be laid in. And so again, it is a cavity nester. The woodpecker is called a primary cavity nester. This is a pileated woodpecker, one of the woodpeckers common to old growth forest. And there you can see the chicks sticking their heads out of the cavity. And these tend to be important for other species because when the young fledge and they abandon their cavity, other animals move in. And so the woodpecker is a keystone species because other animals are dependent on the cavity that the woodpecker creates for their homes. The animals that move into the abandoned cavities are called secondary cavity nesters. A number of birds are secondary cavity nesters. One example is this mountain chickadee. Other animals that use the abandoned cavities are things like flying squirrels. And so again, the woodpecker, the primary cavity nester, is a keystone species because these animals depend on them to provide homes. Another characteristics of old growth forests are epiphytes. Epiphytes are plants that grow on other plants. Epi means upon, phyte means plant. And in an old growth forest, most of the epiphytes are lichens. And so all the green that you see growing on these branches are epiphytic lichens. Well, what is a lichen? A lichen is actually a combination of two organisms, an algae and a fungus. And so it's an example of symbiosis. Symbiosis refers to a state when two organisms are living as one. Sym means together, bio means life, symbiotic, living together. And most people believe that lichens represent a type of symbiosis called mutualism, where both organisms benefit from the relationships.